Welcome to the Kenny Hack. Hello everybody, for this video we're going to be going over how I made this sunset image using my laser engraver. Something a little different on this project, instead of using a canvas or tile, I'm using half-inch MDF. I'm really starting to like to use MDF for painted projects over canvas and tile, just as it has a lot more benefits, I think, than drawbacks. For one, it's readily available in most all countries. I've talked to people in Africa, Asia, a lot of parts of Europe, and a lot of places have difficulty finding the varieties of plywood that we can get here in the U.S., but it seems like MDF is something that is pretty well available in a lot of countries. Some other benefits is that it's as flat and smooth as tile, but doesn't break as easily, and you can cut it to any size you want, and it doesn't have the texture of canvas, so it just makes for an overall smoother image. So I'm going to start off by painting a base coat of white. I'm really not going to be burning down into the white layer for this. This is mostly just kind of acting as a primer, so the follow-up colors won't soak into the wood as much, and hopefully it'll stay in as a thicker layer. Now, something that I'm doing different than maybe some other people is I am not applying all of these colors as its own layer. I am basically applying this, all the colors, at the same time as one coat. And they're all applied together as a wet layer. They're not dried in between. Now, I did kind of mess up on this project when I apply the red coat here. I should have carried that red all the way to the edge. I kind of end up with a little gap in some of my overlays where it doesn't go as thick, and it kind of caused me to have to change how I do the final project. I couldn't really burn as deep to try to get into the colors. I kind of had to stay pretty shallow, otherwise I kind of got into where that gap in the overlay was at. If I'd have kind of made sure I had more overlap area and I stayed a good thick layer of paint off the white, I think it would have turned out better, but this is for educational purposes, and I'm always the kind to show my mistakes. Like, once again, if I'd have carried that red all the way to the edge and then overlapped the blue and then the purple, I think I'd have got a better final result of brighter colors on the end. But as it turned out, I kind of had to just barely cut to the color, and so the overall image came out a little bit darker than I was originally hoping, but mistakes happen. And we'll move on and fix it from there. Also, my recording of putting the black coat on didn't get saved. Basically, I applied that a lot like the first coat of white, where I just took a single pass, doing a 50% overlap, and only put it on as one single coat. You want to put on that black layer as a thin, even layer, so it doesn't take very much laser power to burn through that black. Here's the original image in GIMP. First thing I'm going to do is convert it to black and white, going to the grayscale setting. To do that, you go under Image, Mode, and then put it on grayscale. Now, I also wanted to lighten this image up a bit, so I went into Color, and under the Shadows and Highlights, and I raised the shadows and the highlights up to 50, and the white point adjustment up to a 4. This kind of helped lighten up the cloud color a little bit, hopefully not burn it as dark, and also added more white into the water area, hopefully to get more color to come through. After that, I went into the scale image, set my resolution to 318 dots per inch, and a size of 9 inches by 12 inches. From there, I went to export as, and saved it as a 9x12 and 318 PNG file. This is the pop-up as a PNG file. Make sure you have it set as 9 on the compression level. So, and imported that image into Lightburn. Here are my settings after I ran several test sections. 7,000 millimeters per minute, 4250 on the max power, 15 on the min, 4% overscan, the invert image is on, and I'm on the grayscale and at 318 DPI. Make sure you have your DPIs matching in Lightburn to what you saved it as in GIMP, otherwise you can get some banding issues. Since I did my image adjusting in GIMP, I didn't adjust anything on the shape properties in Lightburn. You can see here in the time-lapse video that on the far right side, this is another great benefit of using MDF, is you can cut your sizeboard bigger than your final project, and you can use that bit of scrap area to run test patterns, and that way you know exactly you painted it the exact same way across the whole image, and you can really dial in your numbers, and you can see if you're going to have problems with your typical settings. If every time you use spray paint, it paints different. A full can will paint different than a near empty can. So to try to use the same numbers every time, sometimes you're going to have bad results. But using MDF with that extra little bit of area on the side, or however much area you want to need, and you can paint it the exact same way and run your test patterns on that, really helps you ensure a better result in the end. Here's the final image after it was all cleaned off. I just use a wet paper towel and just keep wiping it down until you're no longer pulling up a lot of extra soot residue left over from the burn. You might have noticed I've gotten some new mods on my 15 watt model here. I'd like to thank Buck over at King Gubby Designs. I'll put a link in the description down below so you can go check out their website and all the different mods they offer. He actually made me a full set of blue and red for my 15 and my 20 watt models. Made a Z-axis, an air nozzle, the feet holders, and also some belt tensioners. I'll have some follow-up pictures of those. And once again, just go to their website, check them out. And thanks, once again, thanks for the mods, Buck. Back to the project. The next part will be trimming off that scrap area on the side that I used to run the test patterns on. Another great thing about MDF is how clean it cuts. I could take this picture here, line it up on my table saw just to trim off right at the edge, and it usually don't ever have any problems with MDF chipping like plywood likes to do. You can't, like, if your stuff is completely dry, you can run masking tape over that edge where you cut it, and that usually helps prevent chip out. Once the board is cut down to size, I go around the perimeter with these Magnum markers. They're fat enough that you can kind of cover the whole edge in one pass, even on a half inch thick piece of wood. To seal the project, I'm going to be using this Krylon UV Archival Gloss Paint. Got this at Hobby Lobby. When I do my clear coats, I start off with two very thin layers, blow drying in between each layer just to try to get a little bit of the clear coat on top of the paint. So it kind of helps reduce the chance of cracking. I haven't had much problems with this brand with having cracking issues, but it always helps to play it safe. Put on a very thin layer, blow dry it, put on another thin layer, blow dry that. And maybe by the third or fourth coat, you can start putting on a good, heavy, solid layer and not have any crack-out issues. Adding this gloss really made the colors pop a lot more than what it was just without. I was going to flick in some stars up at the top of the image since it was so dark. I didn't think adding a couple stars probably wouldn't hurt the effect of the image. If you want to get really good at doing sunset style paintings and fades, I suggest you look up some how-to videos on space spray paint art. Basically doing rattle can spray paint, and they do space sceneries really fast. It only takes them a minute to get them done, and they do really good transitions of colors and really good how-to videos on how to create stars, different ways of doing that, different effects you can do with spray paint. It was a hobby I got into about 10 years ago, and it's kind of trying to combine that hobby with this hobby. Here's the exact same image, but where I painted the base layers on thicker, and I was able to get a little brighter of colors to come through, but I didn't have any video of doing that project, so I kind of had to redo it. This here is a space scene I did using a lot of the same techniques I used in this video. Just something fun to try. Well, thanks for joining me. Hope you learned something. Hope it was educational and fun. Hope it gave you some new ideas of projects to try. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe, and we'll see you all on the next video.